Once again, teachers have found themselves in a predicament after the closure of schools. Private teachers are especially worried that they may not be able to make ends meet since they are now out of jobs. In Entebbe, the teachers we spoke to say they plan on resuming on their side businesses to make ends meet. We have the report.
During the presidential address on Sunday, President Yoweri Museveni directed that all schools close as the country battles the spread of COVID-19 in schools. We visited some schools to assess how teachers are coping. This is Fred Katambala, a journalist and lecturer at Nkumba University. We found him in Chitaka, where he runs a welding shop. He wants the government to bail out teachers by fulfilling the pledge of 20 billion Ugandan shillings.
One thing I would like to tell my fellow teachers, that however much we are in this lockdown, we can still survive. Let's be creative enough that we should not be demeaned to just beggars, that every time such a thing happens, that we are running into government, that please the government should come to rescue us. First and foremost, me as a teacher, I thought that this thing can happen in life. I had to put up this small business of welding, and honestly, in the first lockdown, it helped me.
Katambala also advises parents to engage their children academically by continuing to teach them from home or invest in technology to link them to teachers.
Because COVID is here to stay. What if COVID-19 stays here for more than 3 years? Does it mean that education system should close for good? I think that's not okay.
Through this welding business, Katambala hopes that he will be able to take care of his family without feeling the pinch from the school closures. Katambala pities teachers who, unlike him, have no means of making money.
Just like it happened last time, definitely has affected us. However, this time round, we are not going to be lamenting just like we did last time. Because the other time it was so unfortunate, we had not thought of that before. But this time around, even before the president spoke, some of us were very much aware that this man is taking us again into the lockdown. So people like me, I've already got my gardens, and I'm going to do gardening for sure, such that I'm able to, you know, to make ends meet. I'm not going to be lamenting just like I did last time, no. The good thing is, this time around, I planted already my crops, they are now mature. I'm going to be harvesting as I eat. I'm also going to be selling part. But I'll be using my children also to take part, so they get to know where this money comes from.
We have also visited Lakeside Primary School, where birds have taken over the compound. The usually bubbly sounds from students are silent. They were all sent home. The school head teacher, Francis Makumbi, says they are trying to figure out what to do. Makumbi hopes to embark on farming as he counts down the long 42 days of school closures. This story was compiled by Geoffrey Sempija for the news.